Good afternoon, dear students. Now let's move on to the part 5 of calibration and validation in unit 5. Hope you all have learnt thoroughly about what is calibration, what is qualification, and what is validation. Now let's move on to an example of calibrating a instrument, that is calibration of pH meter. Let's see about how we are going to calibrate pH meter. So before moving on to calibration, here is the standard operating procedure sample format for pH meter what we are using in our laboratory. Okay, and you can use this document for SOP purpose under documentation in the unit 4 and also for calibration purpose. So before doing calibration, we should know how to operate instrument. So what are the parts present in the pH meter? Hope you all have used pH meter, right? So what are the parts present in it? A display, a temperature knob, a calibration knob, a pH and millivolt adjustment knob, and then standby mode and read mode knob. Along with that, electrode, a glass electrode. It has glass electrode which will be filled with an electrolyte, that is potassium chloride. Okay, so these are about the parts of pH meter, and on the back side it will be having a power, main power switch. Okay, you can observe the photo of Elico pH meter in the previous slide, where you can find all the parts present in the pH meter so that you can easily operate the instrument. Here is the calibration procedure for the pH 4, pH 7 and pH 9.2 buffers. So how it is calibrated? By using buffers. What are the buffers we are using? There are three types of buffers: acidic, basic and neutral buffers. For acidic, the pH 4, and for basic, pH 9.2, and for neutral, 7 pH is preferred. Here first select the pH mode in the instrument, then set the temperature control knob to 25 degrees Celsius, that is ambient temperature. Then rinse the electrode with deionized water and blot dry using a piece of tissue. Electrode must be washed with the distilled water, and then it must be cleaned with a tissue paper, what we are using for cuvette, cleaning cuvette we will be using, right? So the same type of tissue paper should be used, and place the electrode in the solution of pH 7 buffer, first neutral buffer, then allow the display to stabilize, and then set the display to read 7 by adjusting calibration knob. So we need to keep pH 7 buffer. After then we need to see the display how much, press read button and see the display how much pH it is showing. If it is showing close to 7, more or less it will be showing close to 7, but now calibration indicates calibrating or adjusting the knob to that particular 7 pH. Until you get 7 pH, you need to adjust the calibration knob while keeping in the reading mode. So once it is fixed at 7, it is calibrated at that particular pH. Likewise, keep another buffer solution, that is 4, acidic pH, and then adjust the calibration knob to first read the pH, how much it is showing you observe, and then adjust the pH knob, calibration knob to 4. Likewise, repeat the procedure for 9.2, so that particular instrument is calibrated with the buffer solution for the accurate pH reading, so that once you are analyzing your sample, hope you will be getting accurate results. For that only the instrument is calibrated. So once the instrument is calibrated, then it is confirmed that the instrument is going to give accurate result. Okay, so calibration is to get accurate result. How a pH meter is calibrated? By using buffer solutions. What are the buffer solutions we prefer? Basic buffer, neutral buffer and acidic buffer. Here is the format for calibration chart or calibration report what we are performing in our lab. We can increase the frequency of calibration based on the usage of instrument. So today we have discussed about calibration of pH meter. In the next class we will be seeing about qualification of UV visible spectrophotometer. That will be the example for qualification purpose. Okay. what is the how we are performing calibration, why we need to perform calibration to get accurate result, and what instrument we have seen for calibration, pH meter, how it is calibrated using buffers. What are the buffers we prefer usually? Acidic, basic and neutral buffer. What is the pH range? 4, 7 and 9.2. Acidic 4, neutral 7 and basic 9.2. pH buffers are preferred. And how it is calibrated? By using calibration knob. What is the temperature at which it is calibrated? 25 degree Celsius, that is at room temperature, ambient temperature. It should be constant always, 25 degree Celsius. Mostly all the solutions will be measured at 25 degree Celsius. What mode we need to analyze? pH mode and also millivolt mode. What electrode is used? Glass electrode. What electrolyte it is filled with? Potassium chloride. So these are all the things we need to remember during calibration of pH meter. So thank you all. In the next class, we'll be discussing about qualification of UV visible spectrophotometer.